10 blogging mistakes you're still making. In this video, I'm going to share with you my best blogging tips based on my 7 years experience managing websites and blogs that make money. So stay tuned. 10 blogging mistakes you're still making. That's what we're talking about in this video. What's up, everybody? It's David, websitecreativepro.com. So here are my blogging tips to help you with your website and blog. So let's get to it. So number one is topic and value. So what I mean by that is you want to pick a topic that you can provide value on. So as I said previously, you don't need to be passionate about the topic, but you just need to have a general interest in it. And it needs to be in an area where you can solve a specific problem for people. And that's usually the biggest mistake that people make, is that they try and create a website and they just want to make money from it. And then they end up creating this mediocre blog with mediocre content. And then they wonder why they have like 60 posts and they have no traffic, whatever, because they put that they're money chasers, basically. And we've all done that. Like, I've done that. I create a penny stock website. Like, I don't know anything about penny stocks. I know a little bit about penny stocks, but I'm not passionate about that at all. Like, it's not an area where I can really provide value. So it's like, for me to outsource content was expensive. And then like, I'm reading it and it's like, well, I don't know if that's correct. Is that correct? Okay, maybe. And then I ended up just wasting all this money and time trying to build like smartpennystocktips.com. And it's just like, ended up being a big waste of time, waste of money. And I continually did that in various niches. Starting websites, I was just like, oh, I can make money on this. There's a good search volume here, and there's like good CPM with like advertising and whatnot. There's like affiliate products. But I never stopped to think, like, is this an area where I can provide value, help people solve problems? And that's where you need to start off with. Because, like, for example, I'm part of like the Niche Pursuits Facebook group. And one thing that is so cringy about being in that group, and I don't want to call anyone out, but it's like Indian guys. And I don't want to call out Indian guys either. Like, you know, India is a large portion of my audience, but it's like, oh, here's an Indian guy with a tech blog. And here's another Indian guy with a tech blog. And here's another Indian guy with a tech blog. And it's like, you know, if I was an Indian guy living in New Delhi, like, I would consider creating like a website on like New Delhi travel tips, like, and talk about all the different places in New Delhi, places to eat, all that sort of thing. And then create a website in that angle and create something really helpful and valuable instead of just being a money chaser where it's like, oh, I'm going to start another tech blog. And it's like, it just gets a little redundant after a while. So, you know, what you need to do is just think about where you can find value. For example, like, I can provide value in the ESL industry because I, you know, and when I was younger in my 20s, I taught English in Thailand, for example. So I have experience in that industry, which allows me to create a website on that topic, and I can help people and solve problems and answer questions. And that's where you want to begin with, like, how to create a website, how to start a blog. You want to think about like where you can provide value. So think about your topic and then think about your value. How you can provide value. And value is basically just solving problems for other people, okay? That's what it is. And so don't be a money chaser and just like try and make money quickly, because what's gonna happen? You're gonna create a mediocre blog, you're gonna have 60 blog posts, no traffic, and then be wondering like, is there some secret SEO thing I need to be doing? Is there some secret spammy link building thing I need to do so I can rank my website? Like, if you do everything correctly, you're gonna experience a J curve with your blog or website. And what people don't know about that is, like, look, if you just sit your butt down and you write like 30 blog posts and you just do the work, and then after a while, like, if you pick the right niche, the right topics, you do good keyword research and all that, like, your website's going to be indexed and you're going to get a spike in traffic. I've seen it numerous times. It's happened many times. It's like, you're going to go from like 20 visitors a day to like all of a sudden you're at 300 visitors a day. That's how it works. It's like rapid growth. And that happens by picking the right topic in a topic area where you can provide value. All right. So next, number two is don't waste time designing your blog. Now, I love design and I think design is critical. I don't want to say design is not important. Design is very important. You need to learn how to design a website, but like, just like with the YouTube videos or whatever, just follow best practices. Like, what are the best practices? Okay. So like, for your homepage, you should have like a hero image, a call to action, then a button, then like your latest blog post or like links to like, you know, resource page, popular posts, courses, whatever you have, and then your blog post, email list, whatever. Like, just follow best practices. Don't try and reinvent the wheel. Just like with a YouTube video. Like, when you watch YouTube videos, everybody's the same. Hey guys, welcome to my channel. If you're new here, blah, 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 blah. Hey, consider subscribing. Now we're going to talk about the topic coming up. You know, that's, why do people do that? Because that's the format that works. So just don't reinvent the wheel and don't waste time endlessly designing your website. So I, again, I'm an, I, like I always recommend, get Themify Ultra or Themify Simple. Those are my two themes. Those are the themes that I like the most. Now, if you want more advice on like what themes I recommend, I have, again, another video you can check out on the best WordPress themes. But again, my number one is Ultra and in the Themify Simple. Those are my two go-to themes. I just love Themify. I think they're the best. So again, I don't want to hammer on this too long, but just don't waste so much time on design, okay? It's more important to just be knocking out content. Even if you just go with like the default WordPress theme, like the 2017 theme or the 2019 theme, you're just publishing content, you're going to get farther ahead than spending like 2-3 weeks like just designing and redesigning and rebranding and going over your website again and again and again. Like, you want to get content out, okay? Because Google can't index, Google doesn't care about the design per se. It's more important just to start getting your content out and then figure it out a little bit later. So just find that right balance. And then number three, very short and simple, plugins. Don't overdo it with plugins. Again, I have another video on the best plugins for WordPress you can check out. I have a dedicated page on websitecreativepro.com about the best WordPress plugins. But again, you just need a few essential plugins. Just keep it minimal. Just keep the plugins to like what you actually like need, and don't overdo it with plugins, because plugins slow your website down. And number four is hosting. Get a good host. So I have tons of recommendations for hosts. Basically, I recommend either like SiteGround or HostGator. HostGator I like more because they definitely have the best prices compared to Bluehost. Everyone says like, oh, Bluehost is cheap and blah, blah, blah. But yeah, okay, they have a nice introductory price. But after that, their prices are fairly expensive for what you get, whereas HostGator is very affordable. And SiteGround is outrageously expensive after that initial purchase. So like, they have a very good introductory rate, but then their prices are very, very high. So SiteGround is an outstanding web host, but they are expensive. And a lot of people are like, well, I don't want it, this super expensive web host. What's a cheap alternative? That's why I recommend HostGator in a lot of my videos. Next, number five is branding. Get the branding down right. So that's annoying, but it's something that you need to do. You want to build a brand, okay? So as I said, like, what, how you should you name your website? Do you want to name it like personal or brand? There's like, you have a lot of different options. Again, you can check out my other video on that specific topic, but I always recommend building a brand. And once you get the brand right, you get the domain name right, then everything else comes easier. And like, part of building a brand that people also make a mistake on is like trying to be a brand for everybody and covering all topics. And you just can't do that, okay? Like, people want to box you in. Google wants to box you in. Google wants to know like what this website is about. For example, like, Google is much more likely going to rank a website that is like, for example, I'm left-handed, if you guys didn't know, but if I have a technology website on the best technology for left-handed people, and that was my website, like lefthandedtechnology.com, something like that, and I wrote a blog post about like the best mouses for left-handed people, for example, and that would definitely rank, because like, if my website's branded about like, this topic is about technology and left-handed people, and then I write a blog post about this and people are searching for that, Google's more likely to rank that brand for that search query more so than just your generic like, hey, I have a travel blogger but I'm left-handed, so hey, here's my favorite mouses from my time traveling or something like that. You know, like, people want to box you in, and Google wants to rank brands, so just build a brand. And then next, number six, is work hard and work smart. I always say that. I know it's basic. I know it's like just very basic advice. But again, like, they always say, like, you can't work smart until you work hard. And it's like, so learn how to work hard first. And like, that's something like, you know, I'm 36, guys. You know, most guys are in their 30s. Like, we understand this innately. Like, yeah, work hard, do the work. But like, younger guys are like always looking for some cheat code, like some quick way to like make money quick or get traffic quick or get attention quick, whatever. There's no secret. Like, you have to work hard. You have to do the work. And then once you do the work and you figure out like how to build a website, how to create content, understand SEO, then that's when you can like start working a little bit smarter and outsourcing writing. So like, what I specifically mean is like, you should learn how to create a website. You should learn how to start a blog. And I have tutorials on that. Then you should learn how to create content. You should learn SEO. You should learn all these pieces. And you should be a generalist and understand all these different aspects about how to create a course, how to create an ebook, how to start your blog, website, create content. Once you understand that stuff, then you can start outsourcing and start working smarter and start optimizing things a little bit better. Okay, so number seven is learn when to quit. So, you know, that's the hardest thing, is like quitting an idea. Some people are very passionate about it. And some, the biggest mistake also with this is that people get too emotionally attached to their project and they want it to succeed so bad that sometimes it's just a complete failure. I don't like calling people out, but like, just one person that comes to mind is Dave Urso, who blogs at daveurso.com. He's been blogging there for like 10 years, and it's like, his blog's not that popular. His books don't sell. And it's just like, he just keeps hammering away at like, I'm a writer. And it's like, dude, if like, if you're going to be successful with a project, like within 6 months, you're going to know. If you do the work and you sit down, you create 30, 40 pieces of content and your website starts having that J curve, as I previously mentioned, you know when you're onto something that's successful, because like if it's not going to be successful, you're going to know within 6 months too. And I'm talking from personal experience, because like edgeofdavid.com is kind of like, that was my blog, and like that's a failure. Like for all intents and purposes, like that's a failure. Like at its peak, I got to 1,000 visitors a day, and it was making a couple hundred dollars. But now it's like, all right, that's just kind of a waste of time, because like, what's the focus of that website? Nothing. I talk about literally everything. I talk about travel and dating, and like nobody cares. And so like, you got to learn like when to quit something and move on to other projects where you can really provide value, and you know that's what you want to do, because you have like these skill sets, you have these interests, and like the world kind of needs that. And I don't want to be a little bit too esoteric or too personal development-y, but like, look, the people need you to be successful, and people need your value. So it's like, figure, like, if you're doing this and it's not working, change, okay? Quit and change. Don't be like what I see a lot of online and a lot of different Facebook groups, is that, you know, 4 years later, this person's still writing their little tech blog and it's not going anywhere. You know, 10 years later, Dave Russo is still blogging at DaveRusso.com with not a lot of like results. Like, quit and move on to something else. You know, because like I did that too. Like I stuck on edgeofdavid.com back in like 2013, 24, like that. I should have just quit it then. But I was like, no, I can figure it out. And then I was like, okay, I quit. Like, that's it. I quit. Like, I got other things to do. I have other projects to work on. So just learn when to quit. So, you know, I would say quit, like, give it 6 months anyways. If you want like a tactical information, like really dedicate yourself 6 months to a project and look back like, okay, write at least 40 pieces of content, and then reevaluate how it's going. Okay. Number eight is focus on 2 traffic sources. Period. Okay. There's nothing more complicated than that. So obviously SEO is going to be your main traffic source. You want to focus on Google, and then you want to focus on one other traffic source. Some people recommend YouTube. Some people recommend Pinterest. Whatever. It depends on like what you're doing. So for example, with Website Creative Pro, video is way more important than written content. Like, people want to watch a video on how to start a website, how to create a blog. People don't really want to read content. I mean, content has its place, don't get me wrong, but depends on the niche. That's why I create videos, because one, I really enjoy creating videos, but two, it's also like where the audience is for that topic. Now, it depends on other topics. Like, if you have a health and fitness website geared towards women, then you should be on Pinterest. You should be doing SEO and Pinterest for sure. Anyways, the whole point is like, just focus on 2 traffic sources, SEO and then one other thing, because you're going to notice with your blog or website, that's what's going to happen anyways. You're going to have 2 primary traffic sources, then you're going to have a trickle of other sources from random places. And number 9 is write for people and write for search engines. Nothing to say about that. Like, that's how it is. I know I was thinking about creating a video, is blogging dead? I may just do a quick little 3-4 minute video on like if blogging is dead or not. But the whole idea is like, look, you have to write for search engines and you have to write for people. And by writing for search engines means like you do keyword research, you figure out like what people are looking for and what they're typing in. And then you create relevant content based around that. And then hopefully the search engines index your content, and then you help people, and then you make money that way. And so you have to also write for people as well, though. So it's like, writing for people means like, if you're writing about like some sort of technical topic, be it like if you're writing about dirt bikes or even like ESL industry, like for me, like people are going to tell if you're like don't know what you're talking about. So you always, again, it goes back to that first part, value. You want to pick a topic where you can provide value, but also something that where you're knowledgeable on, and you're not going to write things that other people who are very knowledgeable on the topic, we're going to look at and be like, oh, that's incorrect, that's not true. So again, write for people and write for search engines. And then last is number 10. And this is just one from my own personal tip from being a self-employed guy. So you want to keep track of business and personal expenses. So like, everybody thinks like, is this a scam? Like websites and stuff? Like, no, like do the work. Like, there's people who make like $7,000 a month from YouTube. It's definitely possible to make a website that generates like $1,000 to $3,000 a month or more, lots more. So like, when you actually start making money, because you should think about this beforehand, you want to keep track of your expenses, because you're going to have different expenses for business and personal. So credit cards, bank accounts, like you want to, you know, once you start generating money, at least like $1,000, then you want to figure out like how to separate everything to keep track for tax purposes. Because I can tell you, like, filing taxes as a self-employed person is a pain in the butt, and it's something you're going to have to take care of if you're going to go down this route. So you better just start learning about like personal finance and taxes and self-employment taxes now, particularly if you're American, because it's something that you have to take care of. And it's something that you're just going to have to know, particularly if you're trying to build a business. This is an aspect of building a business. You have to keep track of business expenses and personal expenses. All right, guys. So that is it for this video. My name is David, WebsiteCreatePro.com. If you enjoyed this video, consider subscribing. Thank you very much for watching. Bye-bye. Thank you.